those of you looking for ways to cut down your shopping expenses and instead use that money for doing more meaningful and useful things, I've got some great tips for you. Do not see shopping as a therapy. It happens most of the time, right? Whenever we are so stressed out, we either eat, we sleep, or we shop. Especially we do a lot of online shopping. Retail therapy is not a good solution for all your problems. Choose other alternate and healthy options instead. For instance, you can call a friend and talk for a while, or you can take a quick walk outside, or you can go for a run. Do other useful and interesting things to lighten your mood. We do a lot of unnecessary online shopping when we are really bored, right? I used to do the same. There used to be a time when I would just browse through retail apps just because I couldn't fall asleep at night. So whenever I could not sleep, I would browse through all the retail apps and I would start ordering things. Things that I don't even need. But just because I was bored, I used to do that online shopping. And I did the same at work also. Whenever I found some little extra time and I used to feel bored with that, I started doing online shopping. Even without a need to buy something, I was just shopping because I was bored. I'm sure a lot of us have this habit of browsing clothes and accessories while we are bored. We think it's okay, what's the harm, because I'm just going to look and I'm not going to buy anything. But every single time, we end up buying at least one thing, if not more. One habit that has personally helped me cut down on my shopping expenses, uninstalling all the retail apps from my phone. Except for one app for all my emergency online shopping, I do not have any other retail apps installed on my phone, and this has helped me a lot. When you have too many retail apps on your phone, you keep receiving instant notifications about all the deals and the discounts, and let's be honest, you will be tempted to check them out. And one thing will lead to another, and you will end up buying things you don't even need. Similarly, if you're a part of emailing list from big retail stores, unsubscribe immediately. The more deals and discounts you see regularly, the more you will be tempted to buy. There is no shame in telling to yourself that I cannot afford this right now. I do not have the money. Even though you may actually have the money to afford it, learn to say no to yourself. These days, since our spending power is so high, we have stopped saying no to ourselves. You go to a store to buy some essentials and then you see a beautiful and a little expensive home decor. Instantly you think, okay, this is something I can afford, so why not buy it? It'll look good in my living room. Of course it will look good, but do you actually need it? Did you have that on your list of things to buy when you entered the store? If the answer is no to these two questions, then you don't need it. Every week, mark one day as a no spending day. Except for your essentials like vegetables or medicine, do not spend on anything else. If possible, stock up your vegetables and your essentials also so that it will be a complete no spending day. And as you progress, you can have 2 or 3 no spending days in a week. This way, you will be more aware of your spending and you will control a lot of impulsive buying also. The retail stores these days are really smart, right? They know how to make you spend more money. So you need to be extra careful as well. Have you noticed how when you go to a parlor or a clothing store, after you make your purchase and you pay your bill, they always give you a coupon worth of 500 or 1000. And here is what they tell you. They tell you that if you come back before the end of the month again to buy things worth 5000 rupees, you can give this coupon and get 1000 rupees discount. But what about the 4000 rupees you will be spending unnecessarily in the same month and in the same store? So next time you get a coupon from a store, check with your family or friends if they are planning to buy something from the same store. If they are, give the coupon to them and let them use it. Or just throw the coupon away. If you use it, you will be saving only 1000 rupees. But if you don't, you will be saving 4000 rupees. We are only human, so it is quite natural to be tempted to buy things at times. So what to do during those times? Just add the items in your cart, in your online shopping cart, but do not pay immediately. Add the items and then forget about it. Sleep on it for a few days, for the next couple of days. If you don't even think about, if you don't remember adding those items in your cart, then you don't need it. Probably you never needed it. It was just some impulsive buying that you wanted to do that day. If you remember adding the item to the cart, but now you think you actually don't need it, then remove the item from the cart. Often what happens is, if you overcome the initial temptation to buy something, after a couple of hours or days, you will realize on your own that you don't need it. So have the pleasure of adding things to your cart, but sleep on it until you realize you probably don't need it right now. The purpose of cutting down on your shopping is not to be stingy. The actual purpose is to clear your mind and space of all that clutter that unnecessary buying and spending brings. And the actual purpose is to create an awareness of what you actually want in your life. If you spend all your money on buying things you don't even need, then you may soon not have enough money to do things that are more meaningful and last longer. So next time, when you decide not to buy something, ask yourself this question. What am I saving this money for? Is this for a dream vacation with my family and friends? Is this for my higher education? Is this for enrolling in that course that I've always wanted to do? When you have a greater purpose, all your unwanted spending will automatically come down. So those were my simple 8 tips, and these practices have helped me personally to cut down on all my unnecessary shopping and spending and to become a minimalist. I hope it helps you too. If you like this video, give this video a thumbs up and let me know in the comment section below. For more such videos, consider subscribing to Wisest channel. I post videos every Thursday. I'll meet you next Thursday. Until then, bye and be well.